Hello, everybody. My name is Sebastian, and I'm part of the Process Industry Department here at Beckhoff.
Hello, everyone. And I'm Burley. I'm also from the Process Industry Department.
And as you already know, we got a new terminal to integrate Ethernet-APL field devices directly into the EtherCAT environment. And today, we want to show you how to utilize that in TwinCAT.
So let's get started.
As you can see, I'm already connected to the CX, to the industrial computer here right next to us on the desk. The next step I would do is to scan all the connected EtherCAT terminals. I do that by right-click here and press Scan. I would then only choose the EtherCAT device 1, of course, and click Yes. So as you can see, we got all of our terminals that we have connected here in our TwinCAT setup. We got the ELX9560, our power supply for all the intrinsic safety terminals. Then we got an ELX3184, which is a four-channel hard terminal. And we got the ELX6233, which is our Ethernet-APL terminal.
Okay, Sebastian, one question. Now, I know that one of the ELX6233 can connect to two sensors, but how many such APL terminals can we connect in one setup?
So the limit here is the power supply, the ELX power supply. So for one 9560, we can connect up to five of these ELX APL terminals and then just plug in another power supply, another ELX power supply, and then go on from then. So there's no real hard limit for that, but only the power consumption.
Okay.
Next step would be to add the Profinet controller here in the software project. So we get the hardware setup, the terminal, and then we add the Profinet controller here. I do that by click Add New Item and then choose the Profinet I/O controller for the ELX6233 and APL. After adding that to the terminal, I can now double click that and have the first setup of the Profinet controller. For example, we can adapt the IP address of the controller itself. I will now change it to 0.5 and then set the IP settings to the controller. We can also change something for the Profinet protocol itself, port settings, and so on. The next step would be to scan the connected field devices, so the Ethernet-APL sensor itself. Let's press right-click again and scan. And after that, we see this window here, where we can already see we have a Vegapulse 6X connected, which is a radar sensor for level detection. You can see the IP settings here. We can change the gateway now to 0.5, as we did before. And the IP address is already in the right network. Then we can set the IP configuration.
All right. What does that button start signal mean? What does it do?
The button start signal is like an indicator which sensor you are now connecting to. So if you have got a few of these sensors in your setup and you want to know which hardware sensor you are just speaking to, this sensor will light up, for example, and do a blink signal. So this is nothing to do with the Profinet signal itself.
Okay.
Okay, the next step would be to add this device to our project and scan it for the GSDML file in the background, for example. Then we got a few prompts here to add these slots, these Profinet slots, for example, the measurement reliability into the project. I just accept all of them. So after we've done that, as you can see, we got all of our measurement data, all of our slots, our Profinet slots here in the project. And what we do then, we can connect it to the PLC. For that, I already implemented a PLC project here in the main, which has a distance variable as defined as an input. So what we do next is we connect, for example, the distance here to our input data from the PLC by right-clicking the value and change the link. And then I just connect it to the main point distance. And that's already everything you need to do to connect the Profinet values into the PLC. So now I activate this project, and then we can see all the live values in the PLC. I just log into the project, And then we can see the live value. So it's 1.3 meters from the desk up to the ceiling here.
We can just show it live right now, isn't it?
Got the sensor here in between us. And as you can see, the value is changing pretty fast. So the communication speed is really high. Okay, so this would be all to integrate the values itself into TwinCAT.
Okay. Well, this is all well and good. We can get the data on our PLC. Now, how about forwarding this data to any higher level systems, you know, like, let's say, a SCADA or a DCS?
Mm-hmm. So we can, of course, also do that. For example, we can add OPCUA attributes in here in front of the variable. We can also add some Profinet device functionalities in here in the software project and connect the values to it. So we send it out, for example, via a Profinet ring, whatever the customer wants to do then. One last thing I want to show you is how to access the web server of the field device. We can do that by activating it under the device, the ELX Profinet controller. Then we click this button here, and then we enable the Profinet device access, which then enables to access the Profinet web server of the field device. Okay, to now access the web server of the field device, we first have to connect remote desktop-wise to our controller. I do that through a remote desktop connection. And then, as you can already see, inside of this browser, I typed in the IP address of the sensor itself. And now I can just reload the page, and it opens up this password button or this password window. I type in the password and then just log into the sensor and have this web server page in here. So now we can see anything vendor specific, for example. We can also see device statuses, serial number, and so on, and live values, of course. I can also use this web server for setup purposes, for example, changing the distances and the application mode.
All right. Well, the look and feel of the web server is completely dependent on the manufacturer, right? It would vary if it is a different sensor manufacturer.
Absolutely. So this is nothing Beckhoff specific right here.
All right. Now, in addition to this, is it also possible to access the web server directly from the laptop or, you know, our engineering station instead of through the controller?
This is also possible, for example, through an port forwarding that you can set up in the industrial PC from us. So we can just forward all the frames or all the information coming from the field device to higher level systems as an sort of gateway.
All right. Well, that was quick and easy. If you have any questions, please feel free to reach out to us. And thanks for watching.
Goodbye.